Hey guys, there are a lot of great things happening within the hobby, and I'm gonna break it down for you so you don't miss out on all the fun. Every single day. Hey guys, Ron here with BBM Reptiles. Thank you again for taking the time for stopping by my channel. And if you're new, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and join me along this incredible journey of reptile keeping, specifically working with ball pythons. Guys, I gotta tell you, I'm like super excited about what this hobby has to offer and the different things that I found along the way. And I wanna break it down to you. So basically, you as a beginner that's entering this hobby or starting with your first ball python or even your first reptile, I want you to understand the ride that you're gonna be prepared or ready to embark on. Now, first off, I gotta tell you that within the time that I've actually started working with ball pythons for the very first time, I never envisioned myself to the position that I actually got as far as breeding. Now getting there, I would say it took a leap of actually seeing different breeders and seeing the potential that each snake has to offer that actually opened my eyes to what this hobby or the reptile community has to offer. And once I started going to different expos and communicating and actually participating with so many different people, that actually blew it up even more. And I guess when I went to my first expo and I saw how crowded most of those venues were and the incredible animals that are on the tables that I've never even seen, not even on Morph Market or even Facebook, but things that people are actually working and producing, it actually blew my mind. And I knew, wow, this is one of those hobbies that I really got to get into and even open up more to see what else it has to offer. And wow, it's been a ride. It's been a crazy ride of different things that this reptile or this hobby actually put me in the position to actually participate in. And That passion, I guess it transcended over to my children and so many family members when it came to the point when they thought I was actually crazy because I was working or collecting snakes. Because, I mean, like, when you think about it, for the people that's not within the hobby, if a person has one or two reptiles, well, that's okay. But when they start going into the 10s and the 20s, then they start thinking something's wrong with him. But guys, I got to tell you, once I took them over to my world and they experienced what I was seeing, they started getting the message and they started getting the idea of how this is. To the point that I even had my wife involved actually making shirts with my logo and helping me with designs. And just to actually show you, this is a frame of a cartoon picture of a logo that I was trying to create about 8 years ago when I first started, or I would say I got stung by the ball python craze. And I wanted to make a name for myself to represent what I am or what I have to contribute within this hobby. And I remember sitting down at a table and going over different ideas with my wife to actually come out with a logo. And this is something we came up with and I love it. And if you notice in a lot of my intros and a lot of my videos, I go crazy with this basically because this logo, it represents the passion that I have and the time and dedication that I have within this hobby and the belief that I have that it could blow up to so much. And I mean, like, I came to the point that even though I don't promote merch or anything like that, but I actually do it myself because I always say the best customer or the hardest customer is yourself. So if you can sell yourself, you can sell the world. So I started doing mouse pads, coffee mugs for myself. I mean, like, I went crazy with stickers, cards, magnets. I mean, like, and the cool thing is, my wife, she even made me this sign that I actually, I guess the light is real big, but this sign, she actually made it for me. I mean, like, she blew it out. She blew it out actually to the point that I hang this in my room and I love looking at it. I love looking at it because, like I said, These are things that I am marketing myself so well that my wife, my son, they actually love seeing those stickers and those different logos. And heck, even coming up with different t-shirt ideas, that's cool. I mean, like, I haven't nailed it down to a specific one that I like, but I love playing with it. I love playing with it, and that's something that I love doing. And you want to know something? That's pride. I would say that's pride in what you're working with. The same way I would say with so many different breeders that I've actually had the benefit and the opportunity to meet. Shane, Small Town Exotics, huge shout out to Shane. My goodness, they're dropping. But I love collecting stickers from breeders all over. I mean, like, I got stickers here from the United Kingdom. I got stickers from Malaysia. I got stickers basically from all over. And I love collecting this. And especially when I get to the chance to go to different expos and meeting up with all these different breeders, it brings out the fun. And each individual sticker, each individual logo, I see that same passion within that person that's starting out. And you, if you're starting out, and even if you have a single snake, make a name for yourself with that snake. Show that passion, show that pride that you have, and let other people experience, because believe it or not, that's also going to help the market, and it's going to help the hobby, because people are going to start seeing the excitement that you're getting from this, and everyone wants to ride that same high. Everyone rides that good feeling that you're experiencing, and they want to know what it's all about. And to think about it all came from a snake. I mean, like, It's incredible. It really, really is incredible. And that's something that if you're starting out, I implore you, take the opportunity, go to the nearest expo, whatever expo within your area, join whatever group you can have, get involved and see those different projects that people are creating. And I know that there's great breeders out there that are actually producing amazing animals, and it might even take you years to basically replicate that. But heck, we have all the time in the world on our side, and the longer that it might take you, it's well worth the effort, because that's showing the passion that you have. And who knows, maybe one day that passion that you have following someone else will actually motivate other people to follow your path. And that's how contagious this hobby is. And it's funny because they say that ball pythons are addictive, more addictive than a bag of chips. But the thing is that you always want to stay in the know, and you want to always have a different variety of the combination within your collection, so you have something actually to add on in any conversation that you might have a breeder. But believe it or not, we in this hobby, we love to talk. We love to talk about combos. We love to talk about projects. We love to talk about anything. And it doesn't matter if you're coming to the table with a spider. I'm going to be real honest with you. If you're coming to my house and you want to talk about Python and all you have to offer or to actually add is a spider, you're more than welcome. You're more than welcome, because guess what? It's just as important as any other gene. And it's a perfect example of what that single codom or dominant recessive can do to actually benefit other combos in the future. So guys, it's never too late for you to jump in this, have fun with all of us, and heck, even make fun of yourself. That's the best part of this. When you can make fun of yourself, joke around, get together and have that clean sense of humor and fun, that's another motivating factor actually that gives so much life, not only with the ball pythons, but I would say the reptile hobby in general. Be it corns, be it tegus, be it iguanas, be it retics, it doesn't matter. We're all in this, and that's just gonna open your curiosity and even the opportunity actually to interact with those other species. But it's a great, great feel when you're doing all this and you're working with whatever you have, because you have to start somewhere. I started somewhere, and I'm not stopping on this. Again, guys, again, thank you very much for taking the time. And I know I rambled, but I guess I'm real, real passionate about all this. And I love actually what I'm doing. I'm having so much fun. I'm having so much fun uploading to YouTube. I mean, this is crazy. Sometimes I fight with myself to actually come up with a great topic, but it just flows. It just flows basically because there is so many things that we could talk about. And there's so many great YouTubers out there that's putting out content about ball pythons, about this hobby, that I love interacting with all of them, and they have so much to offer. And you, even if you haven't started your own channel, go ahead and start it. You know, get in front of a camera, even if it's a cell phone, show what you have, show that pride and build up that emotion that you have with this, and you're gonna see that it's gonna flower into so many things that you probably never expected. Then again, there I go again, rambling again. But anyway, I just wanna say this is a great hobby. This is the best hobby I can actually say to be in, and the people are great. You're great. The community is incredible, and it's only gonna get better. So don't miss out. Don't miss out on that chance of having that fun, creating your own logo, making your own stickers, making your own shirts. Doesn't care what it is, but show the pride that you have within this hobby and share it with so many people. You're gonna see how that's gonna spread real fast. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for stopping by. Again, if you're new, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. I promise this is gonna be a great ride, and I have so much that I would love to offer and show during the way. And just for the fun of it, I'm gonna make fun of myself. I made a silly video. My son hates it. I mean, like, but he tells me that I make him cringe too much with the different things that I do. But heck, that's part of having fun with all this. So until the next time, I'll see you in the next video. Oh yeah. Don't forget to subscribe.
I tried to stop, but I can't stop. I just can't stop clicking the button. I don't know. All I remember was she wear the Skechers. The light up ones.
Shiny bad with the Skechers on. Follow on your hand, make you my girl. Light up Skechers. Light up my van. Shiny bad with the Skechers on. Follow on your hand, make you my girl. Light up Skechers. Light up my van. I like your Skechers. You like me, my Gucci shoes. I'll buy you that purse only if you show me your boobs. I like your Skechers. You like me too. Bring your friends, all of us in the boot. That little bitch on my trip make a rule. Brand new bitch, come and sit in the group.
Now let's clean some snakes.